guys. My name is Ben, and we are going to brew some coffee today called Nuevo Amanecer. Before I tell you a bunch of information about this coffee, I'm going to get started with my brewing. I've got some freshly ground Nuevo Amanecer here. I'm going to add it to my brewer, and I'm going to get a little pre-wet going. I'm eventually going to add 500 grams of water to this brew. So, Nuevo Amanecer. This coffee is from Nariño, Colombia. Nariño is a department in Colombia. It's kind of like a state. It's got really good altitude. For this coffee specifically, it's between like 1700 and 2200 meters thereabouts. It's right on the border of Ecuador. And it also is right next to a volcano called the Galeras volcano. And volcanic soil is actually really good for growing coffee. There's a lot of nutrients in the soil that you get, which helps make coffee grow nice. So this area of Colombia has been growing coffee for a pretty long period of time, but up until 2012, the producers in the area didn't really have a lot of resources for getting feedback about how their coffee was doing. They would sell them and get, you know, to local exporters and get a little bit of money for them, but they weren't really armed with a lot of, you know, information and tools to improve their quality or get better prices. In 2012, Catholic Relief Services started a project called Borderlands, which we were actually, Counterculture was on the advisory board for way back in 2012. And what this Borderlands project did was it helped create some associations in a lot of these communities that gave them really valuable tools like, you know, marketing power for, you know, selling their coffee to roasters and exporters. And as well, it gave them, you know, tools and resources for things like knowing how they're getting feedback on how their coffee tastes. And, you know, knowing, you know, getting advice on inputs and things like that. And so since 2012, the quality in this area has really grown and the prices that the producers are getting has grown as well, which is really awesome. The varieties of this coffee, if you're into knowing what varieties of coffee are, is Castillo, Colombia, which is like a Cachemire type variety from Colombia, and Caturra, which is like a dwarf Bourbon. So for all you variety nerds out there, there's your info. So this is going to drip out, and after it's finished dripping out, we're going to taste it, and I'm gonna let you know what I think about it. While it's dripping out, I will tell you that on the bag, we have notes of orange, brown sugar, and crisp. But let's see if it's true. I bet it will be. All right, let's see how we did here. Smells nice. Definitely crisp. I would also say that it's got some creaminess to it, which is really nice. It kind of coats your palate a little bit, which is very enjoyable. One thing that's nice about this coffee too, that I like about this coffee personally, is it has really nice acidity. Acidity is one of those things in coffee that can sometimes be out of balance and it can get a little bit too intense, and the opposite side of the spectrum is there's not quite enough. And this has some really nice acidity. It's really kind of well balanced. It reminds me of, like, apologies for getting nerdy, like a 70% cacao dark chocolate. You know, like it's got like a little bite to it. That's what I'm talking. Not 85%, not the really intense stuff, but like 70%. Sorry for being a nerd there. Definitely get the orange note as well. It's almost even like a broader kind of citrus thing. Definitely kind of some orange flavor, but I would also say, you know, maybe like almost a hint of grapefruit as well. Part of that's kind of tying in the perceived acidity a little bit, but it's a very nice flavor. Definitely sweet. Brown sugar, I think, is a really good descriptor of this as well. It reminds me of Sugar in the Raw, if you've read those Sugar in the Raw packets, or Demerara sugar. Very similar to that and very tasty. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoy this coffee as much as we do, and we'll see you next time.